We just had some new seismic activity near Gakkel Supervolcano, a magnitude 4.9 earthquake, and then a magnitude 4.6 followed shortly afterwards. This all occurring in the past 24 hours. And since I've talked about Gakkel Supervolcano quite extensively on my channel, I wanted to create a quick update for you in the context of these two earthquakes, because when I saw these erupt in their location, I knew that was right on the regional basement uplift that is in this area, and so it seems to be connected to this supervolcano. Switching to Google Earth, we can see everything that's happening in the Arctic Circle as it relates to Gakkel Supervolcano. We have the movement of the North Magnetic Pole from the Canadian flux globe to the Siberian flux globe. And over the next 20 years or so, it's going to be passing right through Gakkel Ridge and the Gakkel Supervolcano System. There was a lot of seismic activity in 1999, also in 2018. We have the old caldera of Gakkel Supervolcano there. 3,000 cubic kilometers was ejected during that VEI-8 explosion about 1.1 million years ago. And here we see the location of these two earthquakes. We have our magnitude 4.9 here, our magnitude 4.6 there. Both had a hypocenter 10 kilometers down. And you see that I outlined the area of regional basement uplift and the positive 200 neotesla magnetic anomaly that exists in this location. This is taken from research papers and I plotted it into Google Earth. And so you can see that this is fairly close to this old supervolcano caldera. It is a bit further away from the recent seismic activity that we've had along Gakkel Ridge over here, but this is new seismic activity now in this area of regional basement uplift, where the underlying rock is being brought up and uplifted due to tectonics and pressures down at the mantle crustal boundary. Keep in mind, the crust here is exceedingly thin. They have even found evidence of where the mantle is directly exposed to the ocean water, and that is extremely unique, not found anywhere else on Earth. They've also found evidence of extreme pyroclastic flows from this 1999 seismic swarm. This occurred throughout the entire year. Three new volcanoes were created during that, and they found pyroclastic glass at the bottom of the ocean, which is unheard of. But they found it here. The pressure is super immense when you go down 3, 4, 5 kilometers like we have here. And yet this seismic volcanic event was still eruptive enough and explosive enough to create this pyroclastic flow that went out in all directions from the creation of those new volcanoes. Something to keep in mind as it relates to that 1999 seismic and volcanic event is that the amount of volatiles needed in the magma to create that pyroclastic flow is about an order of magnitude more than it is for most normal volcanic eruptions. So instead of it being about 1.5% CO2, there is about 13.5% minimum CO2 dissolved within that magma, meaning that when it does finally volatilize and it transitions into a gas, it is extremely explosive in power, and that very well could explain why we have such a huge caldera here at the bottom of the ocean, making the Gakkel supervolcano eruption from 1.1 million years ago one of the strongest volcanic eruptions that we have ever observed. To get a look at the raw data, I went to the NSF SAGE website. I'll put a link in the video description, which allows you to look at the raw waveform data for these different seismograph stations around the Earth. And the closest station that we have to those two epicenters is the TIXI station out of Russia. And here we have that data going from the 28th of September through the 29th. This is all in universal time. We see our magnitude 4.9 earthquake there. Very clear spike across the different component directions. BH1 up top, BH2 down below, and then BHZ. And then we have our magnitude 4.6 rupture on the 29th today. And we see that also here, though not as clearly. It is a bit weaker, and that seismic station is kind of far away from the epicenter of these two earthquakes. And so it's not the most obvious on this data, but we do see them show up amongst the backdrop of local noise. Our BH1 component is our east and west direction, and then our BH2 component is our north and south direction. And we can see the spike is greater in that north-south direction because the earthquake occurred to the north of the station. What we see with this first magnitude 4.9 is a pretty nice spike in the Z component, the vertical direction, showing that there was quite a bit of movement in that vertical component, even though this is only a magnitude 4.9 earthquake. Again, this is not a super powerful earthquake, magnitude 6 or 7 or 8. Right? But we are seeing some new seismic activity right next to that Gakkel supervolcano. And so I wanted to fill you in on what was happening there and to provide you a brief overview of the situation. We have a lot of new subscribers to the channel. Welcome. Thank you so much. If you are not aware of the situation, I will link the video describing the movement of the magnetic pole in the northern hemisphere, the south magnetic pole technically, through this part of the Arctic Circle, Gakkel Ridge and the Gakkel Supervolcano System, and what that could mean over the next 20 to 30 years, because energy flows down that magnetic pole into that part of the planet at a greater percentage than other places. And so when you have a supervolcano system underneath the magnetic pole, we don't really know what that means. And now we have these two new earthquakes that popped off right in this zone of regional basement uplift where there is a magnetic anomaly of over 200 nanotesla, which is quite significant. So go to the video description to watch that video or click on your screen right here. I also have a 1 hour deep dive on this topic for those of you who really want to understand what is occurring, and all the research papers are linked in that video description. Thank you all so much. Have a great day, and I'll see you all in the next video.